Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about typecasting. Okay, so typecasting and types of typecastings. And we are discussing in this video these two things. Okay, in the previous video, we learned about how to evaluate an arithmetic expression. In the previous videos, we are discussing about operators and with examples. Okay. In this video, we need to learn about typecasting. Typecasting is nothing but the process of converting from one data type into another data type is called typecasting. Okay. Now, we are learning in detail. So, in this topic, we are discussing about typecasting. Okay. Typecasting, the process of converting from one data type to another data type is called typecasting. Okay. In C, there are two types of typecasting: implicit typecasting, also called as automatically typecasting, converting a smaller type to a larger type. Okay, so byte is not there. Short to chart, sort, and character, int, long, float, and double. Here, when converting from sort to character or sort to int, sort to long or sort to float or sort to double, there is no typecasting mechanism is required. Okay, if you want to convert from character to sort, it required typecasting. Okay, similarly, explicit typecasting, it is also called as a manual typecasting. Manually we need to converting a large type to a smaller type. So in this, double to float, double to long, double to int, some float to double is easy, but double to float is little bit difficult for you to handle. This is called explicit typecasting. Okay, now implicit typecasting, also called automatically typecasting, also called as widening conversion, takes place when two data types are automatically converted. This happens when the two data types are compatible. When we assign value of a smaller data type to a bigger data type. So let us take a small example. Here, int my int is equal to 9, double my int is equal to my double is equal to my int. So int 9 is assigned to double with 9.0. Okay. So now we need to print my int, it gives 9 is the output. When I am printing my double, it gives 9.0 is the value output is given to us. Okay, so this is no way we are using typecasting mechanism. So second one is explicit typecasting. It is also called as manual typecasting. If you want to assign a value of larger data type to a smaller data type, we perform explicit typecasting or narrowing. This is useful for incompatible data types where automatic conversion cannot be done. Here, target type specifies the desired type to convert the specified value to. Okay, so the syntax for typecasting is, first one, data type 1, variable 1. Now, variable 2 is equal to data type 2, variable 2 is equal to data type 2, variable 1. This is the one way of representation. Similarly, data type 2, variable 2 is equal to data type 2 and variable 2. In any one of the technique, we are converting from one data type into another data type. We need to use this syntax for converting from one data type into another data type. Here we are taking double, my double 9.78. After that, the double is converted into an integer type with typecasting effect. And I am printing my double as well as the int. Automatically it prints the type conversion value. So for printing double, the format specifier is LF. Here also I am using LF for format specifier as this. For percentage D for integer. Okay, so I hope you understand the concept. Okay, in the next session we will do it in a practical way, means implicit typecasting as well as the explicit typecasting with example. Okay, so in this video we learned about what is typecasting and types of typecasting with an examples. Typecasting is nothing but the process of converting one data type into another data type is called typecasting. They are classified into two types. One is implicit typecasting, automatic typecasting, or narrow typecasting, widening typecasting are same and automatically done. There is no human interaction or no manual requirement is not required for converting it. The second one is explicit typecasting. It is also named as manually typecasting or narrow typecasting. Forcefully we are converting from one data type into another data type with a specific rules. Here also we are mentioning this diagram, this level of conversion. This is the most important, how we are converting from one data type into another data type. Without knowing this knowledge, we can't do anything. So, my dear friends, in the next video, we will explain you practically how we are converting from one data type into another data type. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.